once the whole world was of one language, an ambitious humanity congregated in Babylon and set about to build a great tower with a high thereof reaching unto heaven, intent on making a name for themselves and remaining relatively localized, the project was begun. The divine Godhead was displeased with such disobedience in the unholy enterprise, hence declared, "Come, let us go down, and there confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech." The sacred decree was implemented. The human languages were born, and men were scattered abroad upon the face of the earth. Dear fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, you may be familiar with this legend, but it seems to me that the end of this story was somehow hidden from the human eyes, because not only languages differ, but even the way of pronouncing words within one nation. So why do people in different areas speak differently? Where do accents come from? How do they change and survive over time, and why do we have them? They say that it may occur because of long period of separation. It may be geographical separation, but also it can be social. And actually, there are many, many ways of how to use language differences as social markers. Well, we all heard this anecdote about maybe the most known accents like British and English accent. But if you go, for example, in China, you'll find that very few people speak perfectly standard Mandarin language, just as few as British people speak received pronunciation at home. You can also consider Spanish in its variety of accents. And if you go to Argentina, you'll find yourself around melodious sounds using around you, thanks to Italian guys who were there in 19th, 20th century, and their language influenced a lot to the Spanish standard language. And if you know all this stuff, congratulations, you may consider yourself an erudite person. But to know and to implement the knowledge in your life, it's not the same thing. So why do we need to adjust ourselves? Well, one of the reasons is because an appropriate accent may provoke stereotypes and prejudice. Stereotypes can be both positive and negative, although negatives are more common. And stereotypes may result in prejudice. Individuals with non-standard accents often have to deal with both negative stereotypes and prejudice. And researchers consistently show that people with accent are judged as less competent, less intelligent, less educated, having poor English or another language skills, and just unpleasant to listen to. And accent can also create associations. For example, in Disney animated films, mothers and fathers typically speak with white middle-class English accent. And you also can create these associations and use the whole power of your voice in order to become a better speaker and communicator. And how to do it? Well, it's another question, because not everyone has the opportunity to go to another country and live there and change the right accent. But thanks to our modern society, today we have a lot of techniques, and one friend of mine, she was learning Dutch, and one said to me that they used some technique when they needed to put a pocket mirror in front of the mouth and exhaling, pronounce some difficult words. But considering it's a bit ad hoc technique serving just for Dutch, I've brought for you, three tips that could help you to improve your accent and make it more natural. The first tip, practicing music. The music is gorgeous. And I have some music background, and I was so happy when I got to know that just in my office there are singing classes, and I go there and I failed trying to hear the music and sing a note. And I failed again and again. But I could hear the music, but just could not repeat the same. And I was really upset. I approached my teacher asking what was wrong with me. And the answer was, well, as any muscle or brain, your voice and hearing also should be trained. Because many people think that, well, I had a bad ear for music, but it's not like this. You should practice in order to synchronize your hearing and your voice abilities. So practice music. The second tip is to hear or watch something and write it down. For example, if you go on the street and see a group of foreign people speaking, you not often can understand what language they're speaking just by specific words. Probably you can recognize it by the whole melody the language creates. And I found out that if you take some video or movie and you start to writing down the whole stuff, well, you won't remember actually the spot of this text or video, but you for sure will catch the melody and sound wave that this language creates. Just try it and you will be surprised, really. And the third tip recalls me my very first class of Portuguese Brazilian version a year ago, because historically established, this language is based on nasal sounds and it dominates the whole pronunciation, this language. And when I came there for the first time, I heard some words like corações, predições. I was there like, our teacher, who is a director of Cultural Center of Brazil in Moscow, okay, right now he will give us a magic tip, a magic trick, and we'll be able to repeat this just unbelievable sound that I was not able to repeat. And the one advice that he gave us, very experienced person, was, well, actually there is a book about pronunciation for Brazilian Portuguese, but it won't serve you for nothing. The one thing that you can really do is just mimic. We all were children, artistic professionals of this vocal sound, vocal art. But the one difference is that now we grow up and nobody will punish us for these pranks. Dear fellow Toastmasters, I wish you to never ever forget your background and be a subtle player and use the whole power of your voice when telling your foreign friends about the place you come from. Thank you.